Is there a real version of National Treasure? Did the Founding Fathers either lose items or intentionally hide things? Was the Society of the Cincinnati or Freemasons involved? Let's examine one specific piece of lost material culture from the age of the American Revolution to see what we may find. A literal American Holy Grail has been hidden in a mystery involving Thomas Jefferson, Benjamin Franklin, a French royal sculptor, and a Revolutionary War hero. Along the way, we will also examine the overtones and interrelations of other so-called mysteries, such as the Bruton Vault, the Beale Treasure, the mysterious Newport Tower, and much more. On December 30th, 1775, General Richard Montgomery fell in the Siege of Quebec during the American Revolution. Eventually, the Continental Congress decided to create a veterans memorial for General Montgomery. Benjamin Franklin commissioned French royal sculptor of Louis XV, Jean-Jacques Caffieri, to execute a design for America's first veterans memorial. Since all the American ports had been blockaded by the British at that time, the memorial was shipped in pieces in lead-lined caskets to Edenton, North Carolina. At this point, it became somewhat of a mystery as to the location of the memorial, and after the war, Benjamin Franklin exerted a great effort in the search for the monument so it could be erected at St. Paul's Chapel in New York City. It's at this point in the story that Benjamin Franklin's good friend, Joseph Hughes, the father of the United States Navy, became involved. He was the governor of North Carolina and may have overseen the storage of the memorial during its time in Edenton. What is interesting is that some point after the memorial's arrival in the colonies, the stone urn that sits atop the memorial was missing. So at some point between the time it was shipped to Edenton and then moved to New York City to be erected at St. Paul's Chapel, a carving of a stone chalice by Caffieri had gone missing. This missing piece of the Montgomery Memorial is a true American mystery. It's interesting that the saga of the Montgomery Monument involves two Episcopal churches, formerly Anglican churches prior to the Revolution, one named St. Paul's Chapel, the other the Church of St. Paul in Edenton, North Carolina. After I uncovered this story, I decided to travel to Edenton, North Carolina, to see if I could gather any more clues as to the whereabouts of the missing urn. During that time, I visited St. Paul's Church and looked around the graveyard and the inside of the church, which was a great historical monument that anybody should see if they're in town. Many founding fathers are memorialized on the walls of St. Paul's Church, and I can't help but think that the church may have had something to do with storing the monument along with Governor Hughes at the time it was shipped there. I did find one interesting clue and was excited that the Hughes monument in front of the courthouse did include a burial urn very similar to the one described as being part of the Montgomery monument originally. At this point, I did not have the etching that had been drawn by Caffieri showing the true form of the chalice, so I thought possibly this burial urn atop Governor Hughes's memorial on the courthouse lawn could have been the urn that was meant to be part of the Montgomery monument. But alas, it was not, but it is an interesting clue, and it is interesting that it's part of the Hughes monument. Now, burial urns are very common, but in this context, it's interesting that I was in search of such an urn that Governor Hughes and Benjamin Franklin were associated with, and that a very similar urn had been placed atop his monument on the Edenton waterfront. Another interesting point of excitement in my investigation in Edenton was the tombstone of former North Carolina Governor Pollock. The arms of the Pollock family include the same boar as the Bacon family, and we all know that the symbol of the boar is often included in Elizabethan mysteries. In this case, it is unlikely that the inclusion of a boar on his tombstone has anything to do with the mystery at hand, as his family had been awarded that symbol for saving King Edward from a boar attack on a royal hunt. So we'll keep that in our back pocket for now. It may apply later, but for now it does not seem to be associated. Next, I decided to travel to Williamsburg, Virginia, to check on some other clues. Williamsburg is home to other strange stories like the Bruton Vault, and even elements of the Beale treasure are present in Williamsburg. So while I was in Williamsburg, I did keep my eyes peeled to see if the missing piece of the Montgomery Monument had somehow made its way there, and in the process, I saw the sites, such as the Powder Magazine and the Bruton Parish Church. At the Bruton Parish Church, there is a legend of the papers of Sir Francis Bacon being hidden in a vault there. My investigation of that mystery reveals that what is being referred to is probably the clandestine burial of colonial rebel Nathaniel Bacon, while the story actually doesn't have anything to do with his more famous cousin, Sir Francis Bacon, or his papers. Still, Williamsburg is an interesting visit. I also visited Jamestown and saw the mysterious Archer Reliquary at the Archerium Museum there. The Archer Reliquary is a 12th century Christian reliquary that was found in the grave of Captain Gabriel Archer, who died in 1610. See my other videos about the Bruton Vault and the Archer Reliquary. Next, after a few days in Williamsburg, I made my way to Washington, D.C. to check some other places of suspicion for the missing burial urn from the Montgomery Monument. In Washington, D.C., I collected a lot of data, photos, and video for other projects I'm working on, like the Erickson Memorial, the National Mall itself, and the White House Meridian. I checked all the possible places where a veteran's memorial may have valued something like the missing piece of the Montgomery Monument, including the grave of Pierre L'Enfant, L'Enfant Plaza, and much more. There was no sign of the burial urn anywhere, but I am working on more specific places to actually look. The headquarters of the Society of the Cincinnati, of which Pierre L'Enfant was a member, was an organization comprised of former military officers from the American Revolution, including their French, German, and Polish counterparts. So this was an organization that is about as close to a knighthood that America has. Still, no sign of the missing urn, and in the future, we'll be looking in places like Philadelphia, New York City, and possibly even Albany, New York, the original home of General Montgomery. The fact that Pierre L'Enfant is involved in this mystery of the missing piece of the Montgomery Monument is very interesting, given all the intrigue and insinuations with regard to his famous plan of Washington, D.C. A lot of people interpret many different Masonic or Gnostic or occult overtones in the design of the street plan, which is interesting, as the plan of D.C. was obviously inspired by the original plan of Williamsburg that had been executed by Governor Francis Nicholson in the late 17th century. Nicholson was also responsible for the plan of Annapolis, Maryland, that also resembles the plan of Washington, D.C. in many ways. Still, L'Enfant was part of a kind of cast of artists in Paris that were associated with Louis XV and all lived at the Louvre. Pierre L'Enfant's father was also a famous landscape painter, popular at that time, and was contemporary and friends with Jean-Jacques Caffieri, who had carved the Montgomery Monument. So it's interesting that in the scheme of this story, we have Pierre L'Enfant also designing the altarpiece of St. Paul's Chapel on the inside, which was designed to cover up the rear of the Montgomery Monument. There are many kind of Martinist and Masonic symbols in the altarpiece, including a glory or Shekinah and a triangle that appears to include the Tetragrammaton, or unspoken name of God. So Pierre L'Enfant is a person who's connected to many mysterious goings-on. He's also part of the Society of the Cincinnati, and he drew the certificates or etchings that the certificates were made out of for that organization, as well as having designed the medals and swords that were awarded to each member in cooperation with President Thomas Jefferson. So we see L'Enfant working with Jefferson closely in the design of Washington, D.C., and the regalia of the Society of the Cincinnati. So the Society of the Cincinnati may have involved themselves in the propagation of folklore and propaganda that supported the American ideal. So this is an interesting concept in league with intelligence services and similar organizations that promoted propaganda, that promoted their form of government or the monarchies they were associated with. So this was a new development in America. St. Paul's Chapel, the Montgomery Monument, and the works of Pierre L'Enfant are all part of that effort. He was also one of several French artificers or artists that helped to redecorate buildings and places important in American history, including his cohort William Tell Poussin, part of the same family as famous French artist Nicolas Poussin, whose name is also mentioned in many mysterious goings-on associated with Rain-le-Château, Shugborough Hall, and more. So here in the form of the involvement of Pierre L'Enfant, we have a gateway or connections to other American mysteries in the streets of Washington, D.C., the altarpiece of St. Paul's Chapel, and now the missing piece of the Montgomery Monument as well. Let's take a look at the geographic scheme of St. Paul's Chapel in New York City, the Powder Magazine in Colonial Williamsburg, and the Church of St. Paul in Edenton, North Carolina. If we plot an arc on the globe at the southwest trending porch of St. Paul's Chapel in New York City, an azimuth on the globe is created that leads directly to the Powder Magazine in Williamsburg. This is an interesting correlation in that the Powder Magazine was likely designed in the tradition of the Axis Mundi. It is, in effect, a copy of the Tower of the Winds of Athens. So it's no surprise, then, that the southerly trending edge of the octagon of the Powder Magazine creates an arc on the globe that trends directly to St. Paul's Church in Edenton, North Carolina. It's interesting if this would have been planned, because it makes sense that Edenton, which developed later than Williamsburg, may have been planned in relation to this concept. It's possible, and if we look here, we can see that these azimuths that are plotted do accurately match the orientation of these buildings. One of the other reasons the Montgomery Monument is interesting is the ancestry of General Montgomery. His lineage goes far back into time, including several members of his direct ancestry that were among the Scottish Guard of French kings. This included one Gabriel de Lorge, Count of Montgomery, who is famous for in a jousting accident having killed King Henry II of France. So part of the reason that the French king may have approved the construction of the Montgomery Monument was because of his value of many generations of the Montgomerys that had worked in his personal bodyguard. So this wouldn't have been lost on Caffieri either, and all of the court of Louis the 15th and 16th would have been aware of the legacy of the Montgomery family in France. Thank you for joining me in this view of a missing piece of American history that does kind of have the overtones of a quest for the Holy Grail. Now, the solution to this mystery could be as simple as the piece of the monument being lost in Edenton prior to it being shipped to New York City, or that it had sat in Edenton for so long before being taken to New York to be assembled that somebody had purloined the burial urn for use locally somewhere, so we'll continue to look in Edenton and other possible places. I feel that if there was a plan to use the urn somewhere else, it would be at something associated with veterans of the American Revolution. So there are sites in Philadelphia, Washington, D.C., and New York City, near St. Paul's Chapel at Federal Hall, which L'Enfant also helped to decorate. So I'm asking for the help of the public to please make a small donation to my Patreon page. You can word search Cort Lindahl Patreon to help in this effort. I also accept Facebook Pay, Venmo, and more, so please contact me at geomancy@live.com or on my Cort Lindahl Facebook page if you wish to help. If you live in one of these cities, please note the picture of the original design of the urn as seen in this video, or contact me for a copy of the etching by Caffieri that shows the form of the original urn. So if you live in Washington, D.C., Philadelphia, New York City, or Albany, New York, contact me. I would appreciate your help in looking around if you're out and about looking at monuments to keep your eyes peeled for this interesting piece of lost American history. There are some curious associations between this piece of sculpture and busts of Benjamin Franklin and Thomas Jefferson that were also done by Caffieri. And it's also interesting that the central rose quartz column of the Montgomery Monument came from a quarry just 8 miles from Rennes-le-Château in France that is also home to a landscape mystery involving a treasure, the Holy Grail, and much more, including the overtones of the famous movie The Da Vinci Code. So thanks for joining me here. This is episode 1 in my Founding Fathers series of mysteries that will also include Oak Island, the Beale Treasure, and the story of the Bruton Vault, and most interestingly, the story of Avenel House in Bedford, Virginia. Thank you very much for joining me. Please support my efforts to find this lost piece of American history that may indeed unfold to include other lost items, such as the broadside copy of the Declaration of Independence that my friend Justin Kennedy found in a false-bottomed box several years ago. So stay tuned for more. It's on the way. Thank you for being here and supporting my efforts.